Okay.
So let me start my talk. So thank you, Chair, and thank you for coming at this session. Why? So there are many sessions in parallel, so in this Spark and AI Summit. So my name is Kazuaki Ishizaki. Today, I'd like to talk about how in-memory storage in Apache Spark has been enhanced to improve performance and to increase the operability with other framework and other resources. Then I'd like to talk about how Spark performance can be improved furthermore, and how Spark can be more unified with other frameworks and other hardware resources. So here is my brief introduction. So I'm a researcher in IBM Research Tokyo. So my technical background is a compiler optimization and language runtime implementation. For example, I worked for Fortran compiler and Python compiler. In particular, so I have been working for Java just-in-time compiler for long years, so more than 20 years, from 1996. So Java was born in 1995. I was responsible for research and development of Java just-in-time compiler. So now IBM Java is released as an open source, namely so OpenJ9. I became a committer of Apache Spark last year, so after the 2.5 year contribution to Apache Spark. So I work, I'm working for CK module, in particular code generation, namely whole stage code gen. So there are my SNS address, Twitter, and GitHub, and slide share. So I will my presentation upload to the, my slide share account. So first, let me say why in-memory storage is necessary in Apache Spark. So in-memory storage is the core of the high performance of Apache Spark. So to process each operation very, very quickly, very, very fast. So there are multiple in-memory storage in Apache Spark. So one of the in-memory storage is Columnar storage. So Columnar storage uses a Columnar format. So why Spark necessary Columnar storage? So there are two reasons. One is to effectively support the first season Columnar storage packets. So from the beginning of Apache Spark, so packet is mainly used for the storage of the Apache Spark. The other is to achieve the better compression rate when we use a table cache. So table cache is usually referenced multiple times. So therefore, so we want to keep the table cache as possible as smaller. So here I show the two format. One is left hand side is row, right hand side is column. So in the left hand side, so row format, so around the memory address, the data in the row exists. So it is very convenient if we want to process the row in each operation. We just data along the memory address. So right-hand side, you can see the column format. So column format, so along the address, the data in the row, sorry, in the column exists. So the, along the memory address, the same data type exists. So if we want to use, if we want to execute a raw data, so we have to get the data in the different direction. But it is not hard to get the data such a direction in the generated code. Later, I'll show you. The advantage of the column format is that so we can easily compress the data. For example, column G case. So this is, we assume this is an integer, so 1, 2, 3. So we can compress, for example, base one, also stride one. So usually stride is smaller than the actual data size, so therefore we can compress the data size, we can reduce the data size by compression. So here, what I will talk in next 30 minutes. So one is so columnar storage is used to improve the performance in several use cases of Apache Spark. So one is a table cache in Apache Spark program. The other is a Parquet and ORC columnar reader. The last one is Apache Arrow for Apache PySpark case. The second is so columnar storage improves the PySpark performance by using the Pandas UDF from Apache Spark 2.3. The last is columnar storage can be used by anyone to support a new external storage. So if you want to, so if you have own columnar storage, so you can support effectively support your columnar storage for Apache Spark by using the ColumnVector. So for that purpose, so Apache Spark 2.3 defines a ColumnVector class as a public class. So that defines a public API like a setter and getter of the columnar storage. So do you think so? Does it spark joy? So let me think it. I think it so spark joy. So let me go forward. So here I show you so how columnar storage is used in Spark program. So there are four cases. The first case is a table cache in the left top case. So when the cache command is executed, so represented in blue, the table data is stored into the column storage with compression. So as a result, so we can reduce our memory footprint during the execution. As I said earlier, so usually the cache data is defined multiple times. So therefore, we can totally reduce the memory footprint during the execution of the program. The second and third case is ORC and Parquet reader. So the ORC and Parquet is external columnar storage on file or other external storage systems. So these programs read a table from for example, the ORC form, file format or Parquet format. In that case, the DF in the first line represented in blue keeps the data in columnar storage in of Apache Spark. So therefore, we can effectively read the data from external column format to Apache Spark. The last one is left bottom, the Pandas UDF. So this UDF is executed with columnar storage in Python. So this Pandas supports columnar format as a vector execution. So finally, so the result is passed to the Apache Spark through the ColumnVector. Then Apache Spark can keep the result in the ColumnVector. So we can effectively execute Python UDF operator without less overhead between the Python and Spark. So this page shows the performance comparison of the data frame programs among the different versions from Spark 2.0, Spark 2.4. So we can see the drastic performance improvement from 2.0 to 2.3. So this is 2.3. So how we can achieve this performance improvement? So there are two factors. One is that we improve the structure of the columnar storage continuously. The other is that we improve the generated code to access Columnar storage in Apache Spark. So I will explain these two topics from now. So, rest of this talk, I will deep dive into these two topics. Then I will talk about our next steps. Here I would like to talk about the evolution of the Apache in-memory storage in Apache Spark around the Spark version from the old one to new one. So from the beginning of the Spark version to 1.3, so there is no data set and no data frame. Only RDD API exists. So here I show you the RDD table cache. So RDD table cache is not a Columnar storage. Also, RDD table cache uses a Java object. This yellow one represents a string, for example, Spark or AI. But represents a string, but in the Java object, Java library, so string object actually consists two objects. So therefore, object defines exists. So as a result, the memory footprint is not small. Relatively large, also the performance is not good. So Spark 1.4 introduces the data frame, and Spark 1.6 introduces the data set. So they are primary API in the current Spark programming. So most of the people in this room use the data frame or data set. So in this for this table cache, so all memory format is used. So this memory layout are defined by the project tungsten. So project tungsten is introduced to achieve the drastic performance improvement by managing the memory in Spark rather than depending on Java. So as a result is string representation is very simple. So this is just sequence of the bytes. So there is no overhead. Also, there is no object reference. Also, so this table cache can be compressed. So as a result, we can reduce the memory footprint during the executions. Also, so we can improve the performance at the runtime. In Spark, so Parquet format has been the first class citizen for a long time from the beginning of Apache Spark development. But in the Spark 2.0, relatively recently, Spark 2.0 introduced a Parquet vectorized reader. So that enables keep the data in Columnar storage in Apache Spark. So that allows Spark to read the data from the Columnar format in Parquet to the Columnar storage into Apache Spark very simply. So just like a memory copy. So therefore, this vectorized reader can improve performance very drastically. So this vectorized reader can improve the performance drastically. So both here you can see the table cache and Parquet vectorized reader. So they both use the Columnar storage. However, due to some historical reason, so at the time of the Spark 2.2, these implementations are different. I mean, so these are implementation uses the defined classes. I will show you the later. So Spark 2.3 so integrates the integrates the two representation into one. So we call a ColumnVector. So now table cache and in the Spark 2.3 and later, so table cache and parquet vectorized reader use the same class. So ColumnVector. Then so this ColumnVector became a public class. So that means any developer can use this class for. If you want to implement own ColumnVector, so own columnar storage. In addition, Spark 2.3 supports Apache Arrow to accelerate PySpark, as I said. So, Spark. So, the detail will be explained later of this talk. So Spark 2.4 newly supports ORC vectorized reader. So this vectorized reader also improves the performance of the reading the data from ORC file. So it was obviously it also used the ColumnVector. So now Spark 2.3, Spark 2.4 uses only one interface or ColumnVector. So this is a historical evolution of in-memory storage in Apache Spark, in particular regarding the columnar storage. From here, I'd like to talk about implementation of each columnar storage or each case so very briefly. From the Spark 1.4 to 1.6, so the table cache uses a cache batch class. So as you can see, it consists of an array of array. Of the Java byte array of array, so each array is a Java byte. This array represented by using a Java byte. So in the this representation is defined by project tungsten. So therefore, the representation is very simplified. But this cached batch class is due to the historical reason, so it is not designed for access from the generated code directly. Wrapper class is necessary when this columnar storage access when this columnar storage is accessed. This implies that there is some performance overhead regarding in this case. So Spark 2.0 introduces a parquet reader, parquet vectorized reader. So by using the columnar vector class. So columnar vector class, unlike a cached batch class, so this class well defines the accessor method, so that can be easily called a generated code. In addition, so Spark directly copies the data, as I said, Spark directly copies the data from the column format in Parquet to the column vector in Apache Spark. So this simple copy can drastically improve the performance. There is no serialization, deserialization, and data conversion. Therefore, totally the performance is very, very improved in the Spark 2.0. So in Spark 2.3, table cache and parquet vectorized reader uses the same vector class. So this effect simplifies the internal implementation of Apache Spark, also improves the maintenance ability of Apache Spark source code for the developer. So Spark 2.3 also supports Apache Arrow for PySpark. So so this one. So obviously, this implementation also uses a Columnar vector class. But the Columnar vector class is an abstract class. So actual implementation is defined in these two cases. So on-memory on-heap column vector versus arrow column vector. But this is a very good example to use abstract class to define the API. So it shows column vector can support a defined type of the columnar vector by using one API. So if Spark will support other defined columnar storage type, so we just implement a subclass of the column vector. So this is a very powerful API. In Spark 2.3, so as a result, so in Spark 2.3, column vector becomes a public class to define the API, so supporting the additional columnar storage. So for example, if you have a own columnar storage in your company. So it is good to note, so this is still evolving API. So therefore, some API may be changed in the future, but this class should be public forever in the Spark. So currently, this class supports only reading the data from the columnar storage. Currently, this class does not support writing the data from Apache Spark to the columnar storage. That's one of our future work. To support your columnar storage for Apache Spark, so you have to write my columnar class by extending the columnar storage class. By using this class, so it is easy to optimize the generated code in Apache Spark. Also, it is easily optimize the data access in Apache Spark without any additional consideration. You can focus on how data is transferred between the Spark and your data storage by using the columnar columnar storage class. In Spark 2.4, so ORC vectorized reader is also supported by using the column vector. I hope so other columnar vector will be supported by using the similar technique in the future. So Spark 3.0, Spark 3.1, and later version. Sorry. From here, I talk about the coordination regarding the columnar storage. So until now, so I talked about the format of the columnar storage, but from here, I talk about the coordination. So here, I show you how your Spark program is executed. So Apache Spark is mainly implemented by using the Scala program, and that Scala program is executed on Java virtual machine. So Spark program is mainly written by using the Scala program. So if you write a Spark program by using the Scala, this program is not directly executed on Java virtual machine. So I'll show you how program is executed. So your program is translated into the Java code while you write a Scala program or other programs, for example, Python. So catalyst Apache Spark has a catalyst optimizer, catalyst module. So catalyst applies the analysis of the input form, then applies the optimization, finally generate Java code to be executed on Java virtual machine. Finally, the generated Java code executed on Java virtual machine, not this program. So this is a very simple program, but the generated code is relatively complicated rather than the program that you wrote. Here, I show you the Java code from the simple program, so generated by Catalyst before Spark 2.0. So this one is already simplified for my my presentation. The actually generated code is very, very complicated. Here, I assume that DF is DF is stored in columnar storage. So before Spark 2.0, while we use columnar storage, while we store the source data in the columnar storage, so generated code always requires a row-oriented storage. So we keep the data DF in columnar storage, but when we execute Y+1.2, so the row storage is executed. So there is a mismatch between the columnar storage and the row-oriented storage. So this mismatch causes a performance problem. So before Spark 2.0, so data conversion is required from the columnar storage to row storage. So this conversion requires a data copy. So therefore, the performance is not good in Spark 2.0. Before Spark 2.0. So in Spark 2.0, so we address the performance problem, this performance issue. So Spark can identify the source is columnar storage. So Catalyst generator optimized code for the columnar storage. So the generated code directly gets the data from the columnar storage. In this case, if I equal 0, float 2.0 is extracted from columnar storage directly. Now, so we cannot see any data conversion. So this implementation is implemented in Spark 2.0 for Parquet. Also, this implementation for table cache is implemented in Spark 2.3. So from Spark 2.3, so we change the generated code a little bit. The difference is here. So in previous slides, so we use a while loop, but here we use a for loop. So the change is very small, very, very small. But the intention is that we knew the hotspot compiler applies advanced loop optimization like loop bundling or other optimization. So that optimization is applied only if we use a for loop. When we use a while loop, such optimization is not applied. We are surprised. So how columnar storage is used in PySpark. So when PySpark UDF is used with the annotation, the data is transferred by using a columnar storage between the Apache Spark on JVM and Python through the Apache Arrow column storages. So as a result, so we can eliminate any data serialization, deserialization, and data conversion. When we do not use this mechanism, that PySpark has a very huge performance problem. We know. So between the Apache Spark and Python, so we pay lots of the overhead for data serialization, deserialization, and data conversion. That was a very huge performance problem. But if we can, if we use Pandas UDF, the performance is very, very drastically improved from the 3x to more than 100x. So if you want to know the detail of this mechanism, so this presentation created by Takuya Ueshin, so he's one of the main contributors of this feature. So he created a very good presentation to deep dive this feature. So it will be good to see this presentation. So in next slide, so let me talk about our next steps. So here are our next steps. So short term, so here and for now, so column vector supports only a scalar type. For example, integer, float, binary, boolean, or other types. So array is not supported. We want to support array very soon. Also, we want to support another column vector type. Beyond the short term next step, so we as a middle term step, so we want to support parallel execution by when we store the data in column vector. Now, so we can get the data in parallel by using a column vector, but still the execution is by row. If we can, generate code for exploiting SIMD, so we can improve the performance faster more by parallelizing the operation. So that's the extension of the pending Spark Jira. So we want to revitalize this Jira again. So also we could use based on Apache support, we could integrate Apache Spark with others. For example, one is a possibility is integrate data deep learning frame and machine learning framework. Now, so we already connect TensorFlow and Apache Spark or other data frame. But in addition to that, so we want to optimize the data transfer by using Apache Arrow. The other integration is with a hardware resource. So, for example, NVIDIA released Rapid. So, Rapid is a set of the GPU library that uses Apache Arrow. So, therefore, in the GPU, data exists on Apache Arrow. So, now Apache Spark supports Apache Arrow, so we can effectively transfer the data, so therefore we would exploit a GPU very, very effectively. So here is a takeaway of this talk. So I talked about Columnar storage improves the performance in several cases. Also, we improve the PySpark by using the columnar storage. Also, we prepare the column vector class as a additional data format support. So finally, I want to thank the Spark community, also in particular these contributor and committer. So thank you for your attention for my talk. So if you have any questions, so I'm very happy to answer for now. Could you use that mic or?
Hello.
Hi.
Yeah, my question is like, you know, do you have a comparative study for all, you know, different formats like ORC, Parquet, in order to evaluate that into Spark and see from the execution perspective, which is really faster in terms of that? Do you have that comparative study done and any metrics you can share with us? My question is, see, they have different formats you explain. Even in version 2.3, we have a columnar vector that's been supported as well. So my question is, do you have a comparative study for any Spark program having its storage to be Parquet, ORC, and see, like, you know, what is the performance of it?
I haven't done the comparative study, but in my feeling, so there are any performance difference regarding the execution, we use Parquet, ORC, or other format.
So if I say that in Hive generally, you know, the ORC is faster than Parquet. So if I come
to Spark,
which one is faster?
I didn't see the performance regarding the data reading, sorry.
Okay, that's fine, so thank you.
Do you know? Yeah, he's a main contributor of the ORC vector reader.
Hello, so my question is,
okay.
So there, you mentioned about the column vector is only supposed to read, so to read their column data from, but
yes.
Let's say when you wanted to use the rapid AI types of solution, actually you wanted to send the data in the columnar format and to actually get the beta in the columnar. So it's not supporting yet, because when you send the data to use the, let's say, GPU or FPGA, then you still wanted to get the data back in the columnar format. So does it support the column vector, or still does it still need extra work?
Yeah, for now we just get the data, we can't write the data as a column format directly.
But when you need to read the data back, then you still need to use the data sets, either encoder or decoder.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right, I see.